This is a video about where to exit a trade if the trade is gone wrong and you are in a loss and you need to exit, basically. I mean, most people will use a stop loss, so they will wait until the stop loss has been breached, and that will close the trade automatically. It's possible to use a stop loss, but at the same time, you need to have a plan, an exit plan, because one of the mistakes people make is that they enter a trade, open a trade, and put a stop loss and just leave it. So either the market goes their way and they make money, or it goes to the stop loss and they lose. However, what I do is before I put the trade on, I have an exit strategy in my head. Okay, so in case something goes wrong, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to try to exit the trade at no loss, or maybe at a very small loss. Okay, that way it's better. I don't wait for the stop loss to be breached, basically. I will have a stop loss, but still I will have a strategy, like I will have an exit strategy where I'm going to close the trade if I think it's going wrong. You know, I'm not going to wait for the stop loss to be hit. Okay? And that's what I'm going to show you. So for example, on Euro dollar, that was a trade I did recently. And because what's happened with Euro dollar, we get a decline here in January. And then we get a rally. And I think that this rally is a second wave. That's why I put it circle. Okay, so I think this is a second wave, and I'm going to short the Euro dollar because I think it's going down again. I think it's going down. I'm talking about the swing trade here. I'm not talking about intraday trading. I'm talking about something that I'm going to sell and keep for maybe days or weeks, something like that. Okay. So, I mean, first I look at the fundamentals, and the fundamentals are bullish for the dollar. So that's why I think that the euro will go down, because if the dollar goes up, euro dollar will go down. Okay. They work in the opposite direction. This pattern that I'm looking at is what I call an Elliott wave, because I use Elliott wave. And this is like an expanded flat or a running flat, one or the other. Because what tends to happen in this pattern is that you got your first wave done, because I assume that the trend has turned down in euro dollar. And the way I look at it in terms of, if, for example, the trend has turned down, then it's going to decline in five waves. That's why I've got one here, two here, and then three down here. And then it will be four and five. And that's the expected pattern. Okay, so therefore, this is not a normal pattern, because in general what you get is, when you have your first wave, you got the A, B, and B doesn't go below the bottom of wave one, you get your B and your C immediately. Okay, but this is different, because you can see that wave B went below the bottom of wave one. This is wave B here. You see, it went much lower, and then it's rallying. And the reason why I think it's a running flat here, it's not an expanded flat, because if it was an expanded flat, that wave C would end higher, would end above the top of wave A. So because it's ended there, I think this is a running flat A, B, and C. And that wave C here is in five wave. What I mean by five wave is, if I zoom in on that area here, and I go to the, like, 120 minutes chart, that one here, there are five waves here. One, two, three, four, and five. You can see this is wave two on the 16th of February, ending the 16th of February, which is that wave two here. 16th of February, and inside there are five waves, one, two, three, four, and five. And that's why I know that it's going to go down, okay? Because that is the structure of the running flat pattern. The running flat pattern, wave C in bracket, is in five waves. And this is that's what we have. So basically, I do a short. But in my head, I've got an exit strategy. And that exit strategy is based on Elliott wave analysis. So I go back to my 120 minutes, and this is where we are. So wave two ended here. at that level, and then we get a decline. And first thing I look at, I look at the shape of the decline. And you can see that here, it looks like an impulse wave. What I mean by an impulse wave is like, it is in five waves, but you can't see them very well on that chart, because you need to zoom in again. This is the 120 minutes chart. You need to go even maybe on the 15 minutes or 30 minutes chart, and then you will see that it looks more like a five-wave pattern, because if it was in three waves, you would see it clearly. You know, if it was in three waves, we would have one, then a big bounce, and then another. But it's not like that. It's more like in a straight line, which is like impulsive. You can see that one here, from the bottom of wave one to the top here, it's clearly in three waves, that, because you can see one, two, and three. So that's clearly in three waves. So going back to that decline, so I see that decline happening, and it looks to me impulsive. That's why I put one here, because if the trend has turned down, and this is the top of wave two, then the next move is wave three down. One, two, three, four, and five. It's going to decline in five waves. So we get a bounce and a short at 121. So just here, a short, 121. I can put a mark. Okay, so it's just there. Okay. And the next thing, the market carries on higher, euro dollar carries on higher to here, and then it starts declining here. So I label this move wave two this time. So I put a two, because I think that is the end. Because if we are in a downtrend, wave two is going to end below the top of wave two. And that level is 2169. Because that is what we should have. If the trend is done, and this is, you know, from the top of wave two, we are in wave three circle. Okay, I call it circle because it's a wave of larger degree. Inside that wave three circle, we've got those five waves in bracket. One, two, three, four, five, like that, okay? However, as you can see, it is not going down, because the euro dollar came below my entry level, because I shorted here. It went below. I forgot to tell you, I'm using a stop loss here, but a wide one. 100 point stop loss, so the stop loss is here. At 22, 122, okay? That's the stop loss, 122. So I shorted here, 121. It goes up, complete wave two, goes down below my entry level, but then suddenly there is a big surge. You can see that surge here. And then it breaks above the previous high. So from that moment, I know that it is not going down. Because if it was going down, as I said, it shouldn't go back to 121.69, which is the top of wave two. It shouldn't do that. It should go down, okay? So the fact that it's done that, I look at the next pattern. What can it be? If it's not going down in an impulse wave, what can it be? And there is another pattern in Elliott wave, another pattern, because basically the euro dollar has gone above the top of wave two, it means this is not wave two. So I have to change the wave count. It's probably wave one that. Because it means we are not in a downtrend, you see, it's gone above that. So it means that from that low here to that level, this is wave one of a new five wave uptrend. It means it's going to move higher. That's what it looks like. And also because this is a wave one, because the wave one is in five wave, and we've got one, two, three, four, and five, so that's fine. However, that one here should be wave two. But it's not. I don't think it is. Why? Because it is not in three waves, as I said, because in a corrective wave, because wave two is a corrective wave, it should be in one, two, and three, and it's not. It's more like an impulse wave. So my analysis tells me that this is probably wave A. Wave A, okay, because we are looking at wave 2, okay, and I think this is wave A, then we've got wave B, which is here, and wave C, because the second wave is in three waves. As I said, it's not one, there is no 1, 2, 3 here, so it didn't end here, that second wave here. It's probably A, B, and C. So wave 2 will end somewhere here. And I'll tell you why. It's because, I delete that one, because the rally to new high, we've got like an impulse wave going down, and then a rally to new high in A, B, and C, in three waves. You can see clearly, 1, 2, and 3. And that is a structure of another running flat, because in the running flat pattern, or an expanded flat, one or the other, because what you have when wave 2 is an expanded flat, it will end lower, but wave B will make a new high, which is what we have here. So you've got your wave A here, your wave B, and wave B is in three waves, which is fine. So your wave B is at new high, above the top of wave 1, and then wave C should go down below the bottom of wave A. This is an expanded flat. So it gives me an opportunity to exit my short position at no loss, because if euro dollar goes below 121, I am in profit again. So you can see I was wrong on the market, but by looking at the alternate pattern, by analyzing the next scenario, and I can say that there is an opportunity to exit at no loss. This is one scenario, which is called expanded flat, A, B, and C, okay? There is another scenario called a running flat I was talking about earlier. In that scenario, we still have wave A, wave B going to new high above the top of wave 1, but wave C is shorter. It's like that. That is a running flat. It means that if we're on a running flat, you know, the euro will probably just go below 121, maybe it will go a bit lower, like maybe 2060, 2070, something like that, and then it will rally again. Okay, so that's what I expect now. I expect something like that, going like that, okay, and then going up again. And as you can see, the understanding of Elliott Wave Analysis gives me an advantage, because the advantage here is that I know that I can exit that position at maybe at no loss, but I am not entirely sure, and there is no certainty in trading. All I know is that there is a potential to close that position, and I closed it, yeah, just at the low. Okay, so I lost 10 pips basically, you know, so because I didn't want to you know, to risk it, because I'm not too sure what's going on, because if the trend has turned then, the trend has turned up, and that's why we've got wave 1 here, there is still a small chance that this is wave 2 that moved here. I call it wave A, but it could be wave 2, because the pattern is not very clear, you know. It looks more like wave A, and then B and C, but we never know. So that's why I take that opportunity, that pullback, to close the trade. So instead of waiting for my stop loss at 22 to be rich, because here it's going to happen, you know, if the euro dollar goes lower, complete that wave C here, okay, and then start to rally again, that stop loss, 100 pips will be taken. So I prefer to lose 10 pips rather than 100 pips. Okay, so that's what I did to exit my short on euro dollar. So that is an example of how to exit a losing position at minimum loss, or sometimes at no loss, using Elliott Wave Analysis.